Okay, in this video we will start with the properties of matrix and matrix operations. Alright, so the first property is two matrices are considered equal only if all elements are respectively equal. Okay. Only if all elements are respectively equal. What this means is the following. Suppose you have a matrix, let's say A1, which is x1, x2, x3, y1, y2, y3, z1, z2, z3. Now let's say you have another matrix. Now let's say you have another matrix A2, which is A1, A2, A3, B1, B2, B3, C1, C2, C3. Okay, now A1 is equal to A2 only if every corresponding element is equal to each other. So x1 is equal to a1, x2 is equal to a2, x3 is equal to a3, and so on. Okay, so this has to be clear. Alright, let's look at the next property. So if we multiply a matrix with a constant, K, then what it means is that every element in that matrix is multiplied by the constant. So you can see that if A is equal to K into A1, A2, B1, B2, this is a matrix, then what it actually means is KA1, KA2, KB1, KB2. So this is what it means. So when you have to find the determinant, you will have to find the determinant of this matrix. Addition of two matrices are done element wise. Of two matrices is carried out element wise. So what this means is the following. So if we have A1, B1, A2, B2, and you want to do C1, D1, C2, D2, right? You want to add up these matrices. You have to add up the individual elements. So A1 with C1, B1 with D1, A2 with C2, and B2 with D2. So finally you will get A1 plus C1, B1 plus D1, A2 plus C2, and b2 plus t2. So this will be your final matrix. Okay. So next, multiplication of matrices. So how will you multiply? I think we have already spoken about this briefly. But let's see if you have two matrices A1, B1, A2, B2, and you have another matrix C1, D1, C2, D2. Okay, first thing that you have to check is what is the order of these matrices. So the order of this matrix is 2 cross 2. The order of this matrix is 2 cross 2. So the column of the first, the number of columns in the first matrix is equal to the number of rows in the second matrix. So which means we can multiply this. Okay. So the final matrix, the order of the final matrix will be 2 cross 2. Okay. Because you will be left with this. Okay. So this would be the order of the final matrix. Alright. Now, how will you multiply this? Okay. So, the way to multiply this is that you have to go through the row of the left matrix and multiply it with the column of the right matrix. And you have to do it successively. So, what you will do is you will have to first go through the row one by one with the column. So, A1 into C1. So, what you will do? A1 into C1 plus B1 into C2. Okay, you do this. Now with the same row, you do it for the second one. Okay. Now with the same row, you want to do it for the second one. Alright. So again in this one, you will get. So this will give you the first row, second column of the multiplied matrix. So, you will have A1 D1 plus B1 D2. Now, you move on to the next row. Okay. So, in the next row, you will have A2 C1 plus B2 C2. And now, here you will have A2 D1 plus B2 D2. Similarly, you can do for any 3 cross 3 matrix or for a matrix of higher order. Alright. So obviously, to give you an example, if you have a matrix which is A1, B1 and A2, B2 and you want to multiply it with C1, D1. This is the matrix. So the order of this matrix is 2 cross 2. The order of this matrix is 1 cross 2. 1 row and 2 columns. So this is not equal to this, right? 2 is not equal to 1. So this matrix multiplication not possible. Okay. But something else can be done. What you can do is, but this is possible. If you are given A1, B1, A2, B2, then and you are given C1, D1. Now this is possible. Why? Because the order here is 2 cross 2. The order here is 2 cross 1. 2 rows and 1 column. So this, the number of columns in the left matrix is equal to the number of rows in the right matrix. So this is possible. And finally you will get a matrix which is of order 2 cross 1. 2 cross 1. So what you will get is A1 C1 plus B1 D1 and then you will have A2 C1 plus B2 D1. Okay, so this will be your final matrix. Okay. So what this also shows is that in general in general. AB is not equal to BA, right? Because the orders have to match, and even if the orders match, then still you need to verify that AB is whether AB is equal to BA, because the order really matters as to how you are multiplying, because you have to multiply the row of the left matrix with the individual columns of the right matrix, right? That's how you have to do it. So this property, to check whether whether AB is equal to BA, is called a commutator property. So it's written in this form, so A comma B within square brackets, and this is given by AB minus BA. Okay, so this is called the commutator of A and B. Okay, now, so this you will encounter in quantum mechanics a lot, okay? This will encounter in quantum mechanics a lot, all the time in fact. Okay? So now, if the commutator is not equal to 0, then you call it non-commutative. Okay, and if the commutator of A and B is equal to 0, then you call it commutative. Also, if you're given something like A into B plus C, okay, then how will you do the multiplication? You have to do A into B plus A into C. So you will do it this way. This is not equal to BA plus AC or something like that, right? You have to maintain the order. So always maintain order. Okay, in matrices it's very important to maintain order. All right, now next property is zero matrix. So zero matrix, is the definition is pretty simple. It's the definition is in the matrix itself. Basically it means that all elements of the matrix is 0. Okay, so it means if A is 0, 0, 0, 0, this is basically a 0 matrix. Okay. So, for example, M is given by 2, minus 4, 1, minus 2. Okay. So let us find m square. Okay, so what is m square? Is nothing but 2 minus 4 1 minus 2 into 2 minus 4 1 minus 2. Okay, so m square is nothing but m into m, right? So what you will get is, let's see, so we'll get 2 into 2, 4, minus 4, 0, minus 8, plus 8, 0, 2 minus 2, 0, and 8, sorry, minus 4, plus 4, 0. So this is a 0 matrix. So M square is a 0 matrix, but M is not a 0 matrix, right? Because M didn't have all the elements of 0. M square has all the elements of 0, so M square becomes a 0 matrix, but M itself is not a 0 matrix. Alright? And that's pretty simple. Now, identity matrix. I think this many of us are already familiar with. So, identity matrix is also very simple, similar, or sometimes this is also called a unit matrix. Okay. So, basically, it is a square matrix, first of all, with all the elements on the diagonal as 1 and all the off-diagonal elements are 0. Okay, so an identity matrix of order 3 cross 3 will be 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay, so it will be all diagonal elements is 1 and all off diagonal elements is 0. Okay, so this is the definition of identity matrix. Next, what is determinant of A into B? Is nothing but determinant of A into determinant of B. This is also a property of matrix multiplication. Now let's get to inverse of a matrix. Let's see. Okay. So inverse of a matrix, just like how determinant of a matrix was very important, similarly inverse of a matrix is also very important. You will encounter this in several operations that we will learn in the next few lectures. Okay, so you will encounter inverse of a matrix again and again. So you need to know how to calculate the inverse of a matrix. Alright. So what is, first of all, what is an inverse of a matrix? So suppose you have a matrix which is multiplying another matrix, and this gives you a third matrix. Okay. Alright. Now inverse of a matrix is calculated in this manner. So what you do is, basically it is the reciprocal of M, you can say. Okay, so it's like if some value A is 2, then what is 1 by A? 1 by A will be 1 by 2. Okay, so 1 by 2 is, if you correspond it to just numbers, okay, and not a matrix form, just let's say a scalar number, then inverse is basically corresponding to the reciprocal of that number, right? Which is, so for 2 it will be 1 by 2, so for A it will be 1 by A. So but in matrices we don't write the inverse of M, we don't write it as 1 by M, we write it as M inverse. Okay, so let's say this is our equation. Okay, now we want to write it as, we want to find what is R. Okay, so how we'll do what, how we'll find what R is, basically what we'll do is we'll multiply this equation with M inverse into M into R. Okay, we'll give you M inverse into K. So you notice one thing, we multiplied M inverse for the left hand side of the equation, we multiplied M inverse on the left. So for the right hand side of the equation also, we will multiply M inverse on the left side. Okay, so we have to always maintain order in matrices. We should never forego of order. Now M inverse, the property of an inverse matrix is that M inverse into M gives you an identity matrix. So I into R gives you M inverse K. Okay, now because you multiply anything with an identity matrix, it will give you the matrix itself. Okay, it's like multiplying any number with 1. Okay, if you multiply 5 with 1, you are going to get 5. If you multiply 10 with 1, you are going to get 10. So, I, the identity matrix, is the equivalent of 1 for matrices. Okay, so if you multiply any matrix with the identity matrix, it is going to give you the same matrix. It won't change. Okay, so this will give you I dot R. Okay, so I R into R will just give you R, which is equal to M inverse into K. Okay, so if R was some vector of unknowns and k was a vector of constants, and if this was a system of linear equations, then by this method you are actually finding out what is the unknowns. You are actually finding out the solution of a system of equations. Okay, so this is the use of inverse. This is why we need inverse. So now let's see, how do we calculate this inverse? Okay, so if you consider a matrix M, all right, so let's consider a matrix M which is A1, A2, B1, B2. Okay. Now the M inverse of this matrix, right? The inverse of this matrix, which we will always denote as M inverse, right? So we'll have a minus 1 as a superscript, is equal to 1 by determinant of M into the transpose of the cofactor of the M matrix. Okay. So C is cofactor of M. Alright. So what is cofactor? Okay, so first we have to see. We know how to calculate determinant. So if I give you M, you know how to do the determinant. So that I'm not going to go over again. But what we need is, we also need the cofactor. So what is cofactor of M? So cofactor of M is nothing but, if you look at this M matrix, A1, A2, B1, B2, and we need to find cofactor. Alright. So what you have to do is, you have to do this for every element. So we'll go by element by element. Let's see. So you look at this element first, A1, alright, and now what you do is you hide the row and the column and the row corresponding to it. So you hide this row and you hide this column, hide it. So what you are left with is B2, okay. So this is what you are left with, B2, and then you also have to worry about, you have to keep multiplying the numbers that are left with either plus or minus in a alternating fashion. So this is plus minus for this element, it will be again here it will be again minus, and here it will be, for this element it will be minus, and for this element it will be plus. Okay, so this is what you have to do. So if you look at element A1, you leave out the row corresponding to it. So you leave out this row, right, you leave out this row and you leave out this column, and what you are left with is B2. Now B2 has to be multiplied with plus 1, so you do a B2. Okay, that is the first element of your cofactor matrix. Now you have to go to the second element. So for this second element, okay, so for this second element, you again look at A2. Okay, so let's write this up. Alright. Okay, now you look at A2, and what you have to do is, you have to leave out the column corresponding to A2, and you have to leave out the row corresponding to A2, and you are left with B1. Okay, so this is what you are left with, but now you have to multiply this with the negative sign. So you get minus B1. So similarly, you now do for this element, right? You look at B1, leave the row and column corresponding to it. So you are left with A2, and you have to multiply with it with a minus sign. And then you do, then for this element, you look at B2, leave the row and column corresponding to it. So you get A1, and you have to multiply it with a positive sign, right? This is your positive sign. So plus A1, okay? So this is your element. So cofactor matrix of order 2×2. Okay, so once you get this cofactor matrix, now you have to take the transpose of this matrix. So the taking transpose is very easy. All you have to do is interchange row and column. So row becomes column, column becomes row. So what you do, you do B2 minus b1 minus a2 and plus a1. So this is your cofactor matrix. Okay, this is for a small 2 by 2 matrix. Okay, alright. So finally, your M, right, your M inverse becomes 1 by determinant of M into this matrix B2 minus A2 minus B1 into A1 minus B1 and A1. So this is your M inverse, right? Now let's find, let's do it for a small example, okay? So let's say we want to solve this equation. So we want to solve x minus z equals 5 minus 2 x plus 3y equals 1. X minus 3y plus 2z equals minus 10. Let's say this is what we want to solve. So first step would be, again, when you are given such a system of equations, would be to write it in matrix format. So let's write it in matrix format. So you'll have x, y, z is equal to 5, 1, minus 10. Okay. So you have your 1, 0, minus 1. I think by now you know how to do it, so I'm going to do it fast. Then you have minus 2, 3, 0, 1, minus 3, 2. Okay. So this is your M, this is your R, this is your K. Okay. Alright. So in order to find R, what we have to do is, we have to do M inverse into K. Okay, so this will give us our solution for R. Alright. So, let's go to the next page and then write it for you. Alright, so M is equal to 1, 0, minus 1, minus 2, 3, 0, 1, minus 3, 2. Okay, this is my M. Now what we have to find out, we have to find out two things. One is determinant of N. So we'll do that later, but let's find the cofactor. Okay, so cofactor will also be a matrix of order 3 by 3. Okay, because M is of order 3 by 3. So let's see how to find the cofactor. So, in order to find the first element of the cofactor, so let's call it C00, what will it be? We'll have to look at the first element, right? We'll have to look at this. So, if we look at the first element in matrix M, then that is the 00th element. Then we have to leave the row and column, we have to leave the row and column corresponding to this element. Okay, if we leave out the row and column corresponding to this element, we are left with the four numbers, which are 3, 0, minus 3, 2. So what we have to do, in a 2 by 2 matrix, we will have only one number, so we just write that number. But when you have a 3 by 3 or a matrix of order greater than 2 by 2, then what you have to do is, you have to write down the determinant of the numbers that are left. Okay, so C00 is nothing but the determinant of all the numbers that are left. So the small sub matrix that you get. So 3, 0, minus 3, 2. So if you find the determinant of this, what is it? It is 6. So that's the determinant, right? 6 minus 0. Okay, so this is your determinant. Alright, so this is your C00. So 00th element of the cofactor matrix. Similarly, you can find for others. So, C01, right, will be, you have to now look at right. So, you have to now look at the second element, right, the 0, 01th element, okay, which is 0 in this case. So now you have to leave the row and the column corresponding to this element. So you are left with the determinant minus 2, 0, 1, 2. Okay. So this is what you are left with. Then you will get, now you have to find the determinant for this. You will get minus 4 minus 0, which is minus 4. Okay. But with this will give you minus 4. But you also have to think about the alternating plus and minus signs. Okay. So in the first element you had a plus sign. Now for this you will have a minus sign. So this will be plus 4. Okay. Alright. Now let's see. So now for C02 you will be left with the matrix minus 2, 3, 1, minus 3. And this will be a plus sign here. So alternating plus minus signs. So here you will have minus 2 into minus 3. So 6 minus 3, which is 3. Okay. Now let's do it for the entire thing. Okay. As an exercise. So C10 will be zero minus one minus three two, and now here there will be an alternating sign, so minus sign. Okay, so this will be zero minus of zero. This will again be three. Then you have C11, which will be 1 minus 1, 1, 2. Okay. So this will be 2 plus 1, which is 3 again. Then you have C20. C12, right? C12 will be 1, 2 the element. So the numbers left are 1, 0, 1, minus 3, and there will be a minus sign here before it. So you will get minus of minus 3 minus 0, so you will get a 3. Then you have C20, so you will have a plus sign, 0 minus 1, 3, 0, so you will get a minus of minus 3, which is 3. Then you have C21, which is an alternating minus sign. So the numbers you are left with is 1, minus 1, minus 2, and 0. Okay. So we'll have 1 minus of 0, minus 2, which is 2. And then the final element. So C22 will give you 1, 0, minus 2, 3. So you will get 3 minus 0, so 3. Okay. So these are your numbers. So now you have to just put them in the form of a matrix. Okay. So your C matrix is nothing but 6, 4, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 2, 3. Therefore, your C transpose, right, is 6, 3, 3, 4, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3. And your determinant of M is what? So find out your determinant of m as well. Of m. So I have 1 into 6 minus 0 minus 0 into whatever will give you 0 anyway. So we'll have new less difference for minus 0 minus 1 into 6 minus 3. So you have 6 minus 3 is 3. So finally, your M inverse is going to be 1 by 3 into and then this one C transpose. So you have 6, 3, 3. Sorry, so this is 2, right? I made a typo. Okay, 4, 3, 2 and 3, 3. So 6, 3, 3, 4, 3, 2. And 3, 3, 3. So this is your M inverse. Alright, so if this is your M inverse, then what is your R? Okay, so R is nothing but M inverse into K. Okay, so what you have to do is, you have to do 1 by 3, 3, 4, 3, 2, 3 into K. K is 5, 1, minus 10. So if you do the matrix multiplication, you will get it, right? And this is X, Y, Z. Let's do it. Okay. So 6, 5, 7, 30. Is 3, 33. 3. Then you have 20. 3. And then you have 15. It's 30. Plus 15. Plus 3. 18. Minus 30. So we'll get 12. Minus 12. So you can now divide 1 by 3 with all these elements. We'll get 1, 1, minus 4. Okay, so you need to check. Alright, so this is your X, Y, and Z. So this is a very simple and nice way of calculating the unknowns. Alright, okay. So now I have a homework for you. So this is your homework. One is that do the following matrix multiplication. So I want you to do X, Y, 5, minus 7, 7, 3, and X, Y is equal to 30. So do this and see what equation you get. Okay. So find the equation. Okay, so you'll get something, right? So solve, simplify in lowest form. Alright. Then second homework problem is for you to solve this equation. Solve the system of equation using the method of inverse. Okay, so the equations are X minus Y plus Z equals 4, 2x plus y minus z plus minus 1, 3x plus 2y plus 2z equals 5. So this is your homework problem. Alright, so after we finish, so in the next lecture we will see something called rotation and reflection of vectors and of matrices. And that is something that is very useful when you do group theory or when you are looking at symmetries in group theory and stuff like that. Okay? Alright. So, these are your homework problems. I want you to do them, solve for them after you watch this video. Alright. Cool.